Hey, it's Azure Friday. We're talking about Windows Azure Notification Hubs. We're talking with Elio Damaggio. In the last episode, we did a Hello World, and we got a sense of how to send out breaking news to everybody. This would be going to all people.
Yes.
But I want to target things.
Yes.
What if I just have people who are interested in a certain topic? So we've expanded our Hello World app a little bit more. And it's become quite sophisticated. Why don't you show us our user interface here?
Yes. Okay, so basically, let's just run the app so we can see it. This is not very sophisticated, but basically you get a sense. You can subscribe for different kind of breaking news: technology, science, word news, politics. In this case, I'm subscribed for word and politics.
Okay.
So what I'm going to do when this happens, you can register through the notification hubs, and you can basically use tags, so any string, to identify these interest groups.
Okay, and it's totally open-ended string, just something, comma, something.
Totally open-ended string. You can use colons. You can use some special characters, but basically you can use them for interest groups, but also other things. You want to use them for user IDs. You want to use them for dates.
So user IDs. So what if I had a million different users? That's okay.
That is okay. You do not have to pre-provision them. They don't have to be created and then deleted. For instance, you might have a game that's running for 20 minutes.
Right.
You create a tag for it, and then you stop sending to it, and it's going to go away.
And does that affect how I'm charged, if I have a million tags or
no.
If I have one tag?
No.
So I can send breaking news to everyone.
Yes.
I could have special interest groups like just people who have iPhones, or
yes.
I could have gold, silver, and platinum,
yes.
or a GUID that represents you.
That is correct.
Ah, okay, cool. So we got on politics and world politics. When I hit subscribe, what happens?
What happens is that basically we're issuing a register call to the notification hub with the channel URI of my laptop right now and these two tags, word and politics.
So the same subscribe that we did in the last
episode. That is correct. Let's look at
it. But with a little bit more information.
Yes. So in here, we have a class that wraps this call. That's notification. What happens is that I have my enumerable with categories,
mm-hmm.
word and politics in
right.
that case. And then I issue the same exact call. I get my channel URI from WNS,
mm-hmm.
and then I issue the same exact call with the channel URI, but this time, I want to also add my tags.
And then if I had an iOS device or a Windows phone or whatever, each of those has an API that is similar to this.
It is exactly the same,
oh, so same
just in a different
same
language.
Method. Okay. So register native async, and I pass
yes.
in my array of things.
Correct.
Okay.
Correct.
Now, I could say I want world or I want politics, but what if I want one but not the other, or I want to build a query that's a little more complicated?
Yeah, so basically what we can do when you send a message, and here we have a console app that sends the message. This is the same console app that we built last time.
Mm-hmm.
You see that this here is a console app. You can do it from anywhere, your website, your...
Some administration site you built.
And yes, anywhere. In here, you see that when you're sending a message, you're actually specifying a tag, in this case, word. So let's run this thing, and since I subscribe for Word, this should actually show something.
And is your native, your client here, this console, it's making a RESTful call? So this wrapper here is really
this is just a RESTful call. You can use it from a PHP backend.
Oh, okay. Pops up World News.
Pops up World News. We just register for it.
Okay. So while I'm using your local API, I saw you earlier bring in a NuGet package.
Yes.
I could sniff this and see that you're sending just a packet up into some endpoint at some
yes.
point.
Yes.
So if I really deeply wanted to do that, could I do that?
Oh, we have our REST API is public on MSDN.
Oh, it's public.
Yes.
Oh, okay.
It's public
That's
on
cool.
MSDN. We actually encourage you to use it from any platform.
So if I had a Python app or something where
yeah.
I don't have an API, I can
this
do that.
This is actually very easy because we're just flowing that XML in the body. You just have to put a couple of headers.
Uh-huh. Wow, okay. That's pretty cool.
So,
and how would I say, like, world and politics, but not something else?
So what you can do here is that you can use, we just shipped this feature called tag expressions, which basically in here you can use any C-like expression. So
operator.
Operator. So we support and, or, and not.
Mm.
So for instance, let's assume that I want to say, hey, I want to have this news to, I want to send this news to everybody that are subscribed to Word, but they're not subscribed to politics.
Okay. Now I can use parentheses?
you can use parentheses too. The thing that you can is that when you use these expressions, you can only have at most 6 tags in your expression.
Okay. But so I couldn't say world and not these 500 users.
Yes, you cannot do
that. Okay. And is there some database in the back here? Like, it seems impossible that I could have 4 or 5 small user group type tags or 1 million, 10 million individual users.
The thing is that for us, a tag is what we're doing. We're basically just creating a big registry between devices and tags, which we found out is what everybody ends to end up building when they're building push notifications. They either have interest groups, they either have users, they either have some broadcast things that they want to do. They end up creating this big registry and they have to keep it up to date, feedback channels, a whole bunch of extra things that has to be done. We take that pain away from you and we have this big registry. We do have, of course, databases, but the idea is that we have tags and registrations. Any tag, you could have more tags than registrations.
So as from a dev perspective, I don't want to maintain another database. I don't want to think about it.
That is correct.
But I do have local settings. Like, I want to keep track of world or politics locally, right?
True. This is because we take away the pain of maintaining that registry, which means that if anybody uninstalls your app, you don't have to do anything. And how we do that is that basically we make sure to expire this registration after some time, which is the TTL of registration is settable if you want to change that.
TTL, time to life. So if I don't log into my app for 30 days or some number, they'll stop sending toast.
That is correct. So the thing is that you do not have to clean up, but basically what happens is that we cannot be your authoritative store of tags and user profiles. So the fact that this device is interested in word and politics has to be stored somewhere else. In the tutorial that you find online for this app, which by the way is a tutorial on windowsazure.com, we store this information in the local storage you want to of the app, so my device remembers that. If you want to have it as a user settings, you want to use mobile services, you have your website that's storing this user specific settings, that is something that you have to take care of.
This is cool. See, I get this now. I can totally, I'm thinking about my Nerd Dinner application. I cannot just register a person and their interest, but I could register their interest in a location,
yes,
or a region, or a date range, I get to decide, or even a specific dinner.
Yes, there's one cloud cover episode where I show how to use tags for geolocation.
Rock on. Very cool. It's Azure Friday.